Hi, I'm Tiffany, the Happy Homeschooler. Today's video is going to be all the audiobooks I found that are audiobooks for Sunlight, Cores B, C, and D. So all three of those cores, all the audiobooks I could find that were available on Audible and or Scribd. Ha, did it again. Okay, Scribd. Hey guys, so first things first, an apology. I was saying scribe, and it's actually scribd, like ribbed, but scribd. So I was pronouncing it wrong the whole last video, but this video I'm gonna do it right, and it's actually scribd. And these are the audiobooks available on Audible and Scribd, and there are other audio libraries, but these are the two that I found that work best for me. Obviously, we're using these for school in this scenario. However, you could totally use them just for fun. Like, most of these books are good, fun books that would be a good read aloud for your kids anytime. They don't have to be used just for school. However, when I went through this list and I saw how many of the Sunlight books were available that I could just listen to on Audible with my kids, I was like, oh my gosh, I have been missing out, because now I can just maybe sit back, read or clean the house, like do dishes or something where we're still in one place, but listening to an audiobook for school, be that history or just one of my read alouds for the year. Starting off with Core B, which is World History 1. It's recommended for ages 7 to 9 and grades 2 to 4. The history books that were available on Audible and Scribd were George Mueller, I love that book, I won't go into all the details, but it's a really good book, and then A Child's History of the World. As you can see, Child's History of the World is pretty big. Now the way it's set up, it goes through it pretty slowly throughout the entire year, but it is nice that they have an option available. If you want to know more about Scribd, which this isn't sponsored, I'm not like getting paid for these recommendations, but Scribd is a really good online library, and I'll tell you more about that later. Okay, now here are all the audiobooks that I found from Core B that I could find online available through Audible or Scribd. First one is Charlotte's Web. I expected that, but I was happy to find it. And it's available just on Audible. Henry Huggins, surprisingly, I could not find on Audible. I only found it through Scribd. Goonie Bird Green is by Lois Lowry, and it was available on both Audible and Scribd. Understood Betsy was also available on Audible and Scribd. The last one for Core B is Happy Times in Noisy Village, and I think that the Audible name is slightly different. I think it might be like a translation thing, because it was translated from another language, I forget which one. I'll put the name that Audible uses on the screen so you guys can see what Audible called it, but it was the same book by the same author. Next up is Core C. Yay! Okay, so Core C I bought years ago for my first child when he was going through Sunlight Core C, and at the time it was recommended for a different age range. Now it's recommended for ages 8 to 10, grades 3 to 5. But if you're like me and you bought an older version, I would recommend looking on Scribd or Audible for the books that they've added in, because they've changed a few books so that things are slightly different. So whenever I go through Core C next, I will be using some books from Audible and Scribd instead of having to buy more. I'll just use the ones that I can find online for free. Available on Audible, Gladys Aylward, such a good book. The Door in the Wall, also Audible. The 21 Balloons, Audible. The Eyes Out for Children, Audible and Scribd. They both had it, and so that was convenient. The Cricket in Times Square, which is read by the man who plays Mr. Monk, if you've ever watched that TV show. So listening to him read The Cricket in Times Square is always a treat. He has such a great voice, so definitely recommend that. I actually bought that as a CD like 10 years ago. The Cricket in Times Square is available on Audible and Scribd. The School Story, Audible. The Adventures of Sir Lancelot the Great, that's available on Audible and Scribd. Penderwicks is available on Audible. About Average is available on Audible and Scribd. Captain Nobody, available on Audible. And let me just say, you guys, sometimes these books, like, I'll search the title, I'll search the author, and they still won't come up. So I literally Googled Captain Nobody, and then look, comes up as Audible, like as a search on Audible, but in their, and Audible's actual search bar, if you search Captain Nobody or the author whose name I forget, nothing. Or at least I found nothing. It didn't come up at all. Now we're on to Core D. Core D is American History 1. Recommended ages for 4th through 7th grade. So pretty wide range there. Grades 9 through 12. Available on Audible, Secret of the Andes, The Sign of the Beaver, The Witch of Blackbird Pond, Johnny Tremaine is available on Audible and Scribd, Justin Morgan Had a Horse is available on Audible and Scribd, Winter Danger is also available on Audible and Scribd, and Adirium Judson is available on Scribd only. I couldn't find it on Audible, so that's interesting. So Scribd is an online library, and you can pay $10 a month for a membership to this online library. And to the best of my knowledge, at this point, there is no restrictions on how many books you can read. I know that I saved several, like I wasn't counting. I would say 10 plus books that I saved is like, oh, we might want to read this. So you can get the app, and I have my app, save it. I'm saving my audio. And I, let's see here, in my saved, I've got the Adoniram Judson book that my daughter is listening to for Core C.
Place the paper in it.
So it's a really, really great resource. I feel like $10 a month for this online library is worth it. And then we also pay for monthly credits through Audible, but that's definitely a more expensive way. I do think that the Scribd Audible process or audiobook process is a little bit cheaper because you could definitely go through several books in one month versus just one book through Audible. Okay, that pretty much sums up my video of all the good books I found that were available for cores B, C, and D. In the near future, I'm going to be having a video featuring all the audiobooks I found available for cores E, F, G. So if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss it.